Okay, today's meeting comes to order. And my friends, we have scored another major coup for all members in good standing. Now, don't concern yourselves with how we did it, because it involves unsightly backroom haggling. Just get ready to enjoy another great perk as a card-carrying fan of Mr. Belvedere, all right? If you leave your membership plaque on the dashboard of your car, Joe Gellis said we can park in the handicap space at his brother's convenience mart, okay?
That's so wonderful, because sometimes I only have a few items to buy, like wine and cat food. Now I can go in and out so much quicker.
Right, so enjoy. Okay, and now to our next order of business is, the nickname issue. Now, last time we spoke, we resolved to come up with a nickname for Mr. Belvedere that only we use so we can identify each other in a strange town or something, right? Okay, ideas?
How about Thaddeus or Big Bob?
Betty.
How about the man who rides alone?
Head cheese?
El Stinkmeister.
Boo! Boo.
I like Beacon of Bliss.
How about Brock Toon?
Brock Toon, hey, I like it. All right, let's vote, all right? All in favor of Brock Toon, say aye.
Aye.
Not in favor, nay.
Nay.
Brock Toon it is.
Oh, that sounds like a Pepperidge Farm cookie, and that's A-OK with me.
Oh, hey, hi. Welcome, come on in. Are you a fan of Brock Toon?
What?
No, they're doing a comedy night here later, and I just got here early to sign up.
Oh, all right, well, take a seat, make yourself comfortable, sit anywhere. We're just getting ready to move on to our next order of business. But anything else? Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to say, partly to talk about it, and partly to let the new guy in on the mood here a little bit. Mr. Belvedere is the light of my life. I know I speak for the others when I say he is so amazing, you know, and he's just, I wish I could know him more, you know, because he is one of a kind, you know, I think about him all the time, and, well, I'm wondering, should we kill him?
For God's sakes, no.
We usually vote, Mr. Chairman.
Well, before we vote, I'd like Pete to explain why he wants to kill Brock Toon.
Well, I want to meet this girl, and I know that she'd be, you know, pretty impressed if she knew I hung out with Mr. Belvedere.
Well, why kill him then?
Because so he wouldn't know how unworthy I am to hang out with him?
Well, okay, look, I don't follow. What about the girl that you want to meet?
Oh, she's probably a lesbo anyway.
Well, I guess we can vote, but we shouldn't really have to, people. All right, all those in favor who want to kill Mr. Belvedere, say aye.
Aye.
All those who don't think he should be killed, say nay.
Nay.
The nays have it. He lives, but the vote shouldn't have been that close. Which, brings me to an area that I think we need to discuss. Now, I got a letter from Mr. Belvedere's publicist. It seems somebody has been killing his house pets again. Now, I'm not going to ask which one of you is doing it, but I do think we need to do our exercises.
What exercises?
The exercise that helps keep the line between reality and fantasy a little less blurry. You'll see.
Okay. Who wants to start?
Okay, I should want to shake hands with Mr. Belvedere. I shouldn't want to grab a lock of his hair.
Now, that's good, Cheryl. And even though it'd be really neat to have a lock of his hair, you know that's not right. Someone else.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I should like to send him a fan letter telling him how good he was in the episode where he teaches everyone how to cook, but I shouldn't want to type the letter on a death certificate.
Yes, but then you learned that one the hard way, huh? Spoilers, all right. Yes, yeah, okay, so let's keep going. Come on.
I should like watching Mr. Belvedere a lot, but I shouldn't have to masturbate at the end of every episode.
That's right. That is right. Discipline. Next.
Yeah, I should want to cook Brock Toon a simple dinner if he truly accepts the offer, but not if I sense that he accepts it telepathically.
Yes, okay, but let's keep the exercises in the form of should and shouldn't, okay? Next.
I should want to cook him a simple meal, but I shouldn't want to cut into him, to tear the flesh, to wear the flesh, to be born unto new worlds where his flesh becomes my key.
Good.
I got one. I should want to say hi to him nicely. I shouldn't want to keep him in a big jar in my basement.
All right, Doug, that's great, and you understand that now. Go on, though. Why shouldn't you put him in a big jar in your basement?
Because his breath would fog up the glass and I wouldn't be able to see him.
Well, now, there is that,
you
but there's also...
You people are crazy! You're talking about killing Mr. Belvedere? And putting this Brock Toon guy in a big jar and dead house pets? I mean, can't you see what you're talking about is wrong? I mean, can't you see that?
Oh,